table for.
Oh, I'm sorry, that's my fault.
If you would please call the roll.
Mr. Granby?
Here, present.
Mr. Davis?
Here.
Mr. Bailey?
Here.
Ms. Blankenship?
Here.
And Mr. White?
Here.
All present.
All present, we do have a forum, this time I'll let it change.
Okay, I move we suspend the rules, consider moving 5D, which is the mayor's appointment, Mount Pleasant Planning Commission, and the Mount Pleasant Recreation Commission. After new business, number 10. So I don't know if we make number 11, 12, number 12, number 13.
10F, maybe?
Or 10F, yeah, whatever y'all think. I'm good.
All right. If you understand, Mr. White's motion, is there a second, is that please?
A second.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Okay, so that will be taken care of. Item four, please, approval correction of the minutes from prior meeting, January 17th.
I see no correction, I move approved.
Motion been made to approve the minutes, any further discussion, second? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Like sign, the minutes are approved. Item five, board's presentation performance, number A, introduce Gunner the Drug Dog. Bring Gunner in, turn him loose.
You don't want that to happen.
What we have is a 13-month-old Belgian Malinois. He's very hyper. He's still a puppy. So, this is Gunner. As you can tell, he's very hyper.
Hyper but gentle.
He's ready, he's ready to go.
Tell him what the dog does.
Gunner is a passive drug canine. He just sniffs for drugs, he doesn't attack, he doesn't bite, he licks a lot. And he doesn't scratch, he sits if he finds drugs. So we search cars with him, we search buildings, fields. If somebody throws their drugs out in the field, Gunner will find it. So.
Where's he housed, Mark?
He's housed with Jesse.
Officer Owen.
Officer Owen, just everything for Gunner is paid for out of the drug fund, so it doesn't cost the city a dime.
Y'all already had some sense out of him?
Sir?
Have you done that some sense?
I don't know that we've had any fines with him yet. We have deployed him a few times, but we hadn't had any fines with him yet.
Will he be in the schools too?
No, the schools, the county, they do their own.
I didn't know.
Mace, he's not vicious.
He's not, no, he's not. He's not anywhere close.
No, Luke, you're a man.
Question, Chief. The dog is very active and very fast. That's not a problem with a drug dog like it is with a service dog, is it?
No, sir, it's not.
It's all right for the kids and all the petting.
Right, yeah, no, in fact, they look, when they do a drug dog, they look for one like Gunner that's active, that likes to play, that likes to chase toys, because basically that's what he's doing. He's chasing a tennis ball.
Yeah,
he's chasing.
Chasing to read an article, Dog World type stuff about, you know, the service dogs, they really don't want you disrupting their chain of thought, you know, what they're doing. So.
Right, yeah, but no, if he's working, no, we don't want anybody to bother him, but if we take him to a school, you know, yeah, he's fine.
I like the name Gunner. Who come up with that?
It was already there
they
when
name
we picked
for
him
us,
up.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And thank you to Officer Owens for all, he's been through all the training and still working with them.
He's got his hands full.
Yeah.
New kid.
He's doing a good job, though.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Next will be presentation by Donna Morency. Donna, if you come forward, please.
I'm not nearly a typer.
A little less.
We're glad. Each of you have the presentation that I'm going to do. This is actually the work plan for the Mount Pleasant Community Development Corporation for 2016-2017. We work on the fiscal year, and so we're about halfway through. I don't know if you know, but we have three focuses for the CDC is education, community development, and quality of life or livability. So these are the things that the CDC does, and along with a lot of volunteers and other organizations that I work with. The education is, right now we're working with the KC-14 STEAM campus. I think mostly everyone knows what's going on with education here in Mount Pleasant. We're really excited about it. I was elected to the school board that's completely separate from this. But I have to tell you what's going on in Mount Pleasant, that this right now with our three schools is the talk of Murray County. And if you notice, we're getting a lot of good press from that. We're also getting a lot of people that are moving into Mount Pleasant. We get calls at the schools just about every day. People want to know how they get their kids in the schools and if they have to live in Mount Pleasant to do that. They do take some out of area students, but only if there's room for it. And it looks like pretty soon that we're going to be filling those schools up. I will let you in on, we have a study that was done by Dr. Jesse Register out of Nashville. He was a superintendent in Nashville. He's he works at Belmont now, and he's been working with Murray County Schools. He did a study, and it looks like what they're going to, what his recommendation was because of the age of the elementary school, to build at the middle school, add on at the middle school, make the middle school and elementary school a K-8, and then the high school. nothing's been voted on it, but that's what it looks like, just because the school. Anyway, that's what I do. I work really closely with everybody at the schools. The Community Foundation Scholarship Program, I'm the director of that, I administer that. Last year we did 9 scholarships with high school seniors that are going to 4-year schools. We used to do it with 2-year, but now with the Tennessee Promise, their schooling is paid for, and so we concentrate on our students that are going to 4-year schools and help them out with that. Then the family-to-family backpack program, I always work closely with that. That is to fill backpacks. I think we did like 340 this past school supplies to the elementary schools. Then Kids on Stage is one of the contributing entities to the, and I sit on the board of Kids on Stage, and we're closely with them. So that's as far as education. Economic development, of course, you know about the Downtown Revitalization Plan. We work, Kate and Mike Redding, who is with MCI, William Moon and myself. William is the president of the chamber. We meet just about monthly and go over how we're going to work the revitalization of downtown, what's best for the town, what's best for the residents here. So I work really closely with that. Social media, I have a Facebook page for the CDC with about, I think, 1,100 friends on it, and mostly are this area. Everything that we post is positive about Mount Pleasant, and what's going on is one of the best ways to get information out to our residents. Chamber of Commerce, the CDC houses the Chamber of Commerce. We give them their office, their telephone, and their meeting place there. I also serve on the Chamber of Commerce. We're working to improve the chamber and improve and grow the Chamber of Commerce, and we're working on an application to better explain what we do, and to offer better benefits or more benefits. We just had the industry meetings that some of you were at, I think most of you were at, and we got a lot of industry interest, and especially in our parks and rec. So we got some good feedback from that. We also had the CTE director for 19 counties, which is career and technical education, and Joy Rich. She was at that meeting, and she will be here the 1st of March. To look at our schools and see, and I was just on the Hill today, and they are funding in the governor has some budget, there is more CTE money, so we're hoping for equipment, so we're hoping to get some of that. Tennessee Downtowns is a it's a prelude, if you don't know, it's a prelude to a Main Street program. About, I think it was 2007, we wrote a grant and applied for Tennessee Downtowns. We were the one of the first Tennessee Downtowns in, that they picked. I think we were one of 10 of the first. It's the only difference between the Main Street program and Tennessee Downtown program is that Main Street, you have to have a paid full-time director, and the Tennessee Downtowns, you don't. And the state came up with this program for small towns that can't afford to have a full-time Main Street director. But we still work with the same 4 points of Main Street, and we work hard on that. Visitor Center. The my office houses the visitor center, so it's the chamber, the visitor center, and the CDC office. We are looking, we're working on the wall to show what we're doing downtown, and working to improve that. But I work with the visitor center and the Maury County Visitor Center, and we get quite a few people that come in and want to see. Retire Tennessee. I serve on the Retire Tennessee program. This is a state program, and Maury County is designated a retirement community. That means that Maury County has all of the what retirees need. They're looking for that they meet all the requirements for the Retire Tennessee Retire Tennessee program. Sorry. And so I work with Renee Winchester, who's director for the state of Retire Tennessee, and we actually we are required to do one trip per year. It's an ideal living seminar, I guess it is. This time we went to Chicago, and for 2 days we talked to people. We had over 200 people sign up for Tennessee. They were interested in moving to Tennessee. So we give them information about our communities, about the state. The state of Tennessee is the number one place to retire right now, which is kind of amazing since we don't have any ocean, or, you know, we're not on any coast. So it was a big deal. Maury County 3-star program. I work with the Alliance and the Chamber, Maury County Chamber, and we write a grant every year, a $10,000 grant. We split it up 3 ways, and that money goes towards education. And then the Maury County Tourism Board, I sit on that board, that we meet quarterly for that, and we talk about how we bring tourism in. I think we're going to see a lot more action as our town improves and grows. We're getting a lot more people coming in. Arrow Lake Recreational, Arrow Lake Foundation. I serve as the director of Arrow Lake Foundation, and Arrow Lake Foundation is a group of local and Sanofi Pharmaceutical people that we are working to do a recreational area out there. There's 1,500 acres of that includes the lake. We also do it's a 501c3. We do a lot of community work. If you notice the disc golf course, that was paid for by Arrow Lake Foundation. So they also do a lot for schools. They do a barbecue festival. So there's a lot of things that their hands are in.
They just gave $5,000 to the Megatronics program.
Yes, $5,000. Thank you. $5,000 to the Megatronics program at the high school. Mount Pleasant Trail of Tears. We're still waiting. We are on the top of the list supposedly for 22 signs. To be placed in for the Trail of Tears, and that will mark the trail and hopefully drive people into town. They'll be out on the bypass and also up from Pulaski. They have a lot of people that are following the trails now, so that'll be that. So, and then lifestyle, which is the quality of life. I think a lot of education is the number one attraction to a town. The quality of life is probably number two. And all three of these work together to create the economic development part. But something really close to my heart is the parks and recreation. We're working right now. I think we've got our third session for the 5-year strategic plan. We probably have two more to go, and then we'll have that plan ready to present to you. I work with Thomas Kenny quite a bit, and anything that he needs or when it comes time, we're trying to position ourselves so that we can apply for grants. And in order to do that, you have to have your 5-year strategic plan, and you have to have done some of this stuff. So we're working on that. We had a great meeting last time just with picking out actions and priorities that we want to do. So we're real close to getting that to present to you. And recycling for Mount Pleasant. I think 3 years ago, we started the recycling program, and we didn't know whether it would work or not. I mean, we didn't know if people would save their aluminum cans and give them to us, and we donated $10,000 to in 3 years, we $10,000 to the high school for the field house, and we're still collecting now. We're just going with the next project, which we're not sure what it is, but we will work that out and find out what that next project is, and we're willing to take any. But $10,000 in 3 years was something. It's free money. It's money that we were throwing away. Plus, it costs less for the city to put it in the landfill now because we're saving that. So that worked out a lot better than I thought it was. I didn't know that it would work or not. The Art of Living in Mount Pleasant. I hope you all get that monthly. If not, email me, and I'll put you on the distribution list for the email edition. But we do a magazine, a newspaper, a 4-page newspaper. I have about 7 people that write articles for it, and it's all positive. We don't deal in anything negative, or it's all positive, nothing political, but let people know what's going on in Mount Pleasant, the good things that are going on. And I've gotten really good response from that. I have 90 people on the email list now, and I also we also print 1,000 copies of it.
I'm Jordan Reed.
Well, thank you. The Mount Pleasant Community Theater Program Company, that's where I should be right now. I hope that you'll be there. Please mark on your calendars Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night of this week. We at 7:00. These are your Thomas Kinney is. See him act. He's a shepherd. We have 13 actors in this production. We have Bedford Smith from the bank, from Community First. There's kids from, I think the youngest, Nova, is 7, up to, Kurt Butler is our dragon. And they're over there rehearsing now. Tonight's the first dress rehearsal, so I'm going to head out as soon as I leave here, head out and go back over there. But it gets people together, and it was paid for by a grant written through the, called an ABC grant, Arts Builds Communities, excuse me, and it's written through the Tennessee Arts Commission.
It's called The Reluctant Dragon.
The Reluctant Dragon, yes it is. It's a great little play. It's comedy, and I think you'll enjoy it. So don't forget Thursday, Friday, or Saturday.
What's the time?
7:00. And it's $5. It's affordable for just about everybody. If you can't afford a ticket, just come see me. I'll get you in.
It's the middle school stuff.
Excuse me. And just lastly, are the events that we do that I work on. Classics in the Park with the Classics for a Cause, the car show, and we also do those three, but this year it's going to be four months, May, June, July, and August, first Saturday of every month, and I work with them on that, National Night Out. I always work, I'm sorry, the Benefit Ball, the Barbecue Festival, of course, that's our signature event that we do, and we will be starting the first of next month to start planning for it, so everybody is really thrilled. I work at the Rotary Club on the Christmas Parade, the Chamber of Commerce Easter Egg Hunt, the Community Theater Productions, which I've already said, the Makers Workspace and Gallery, that's upstairs above my office. We've had three different shows now. We had a showing with teachers from our school called Artists Teaching Artist, and we had about 75 people up there for the opening. And then we also had a student art, the high school student art gallery was opening was up there. And they go really well and bring people in, and people are amazed at the talent that we have in this town. Host of the town Chamber of Commerce, the annual banquet, excuse me, and then music and movies on the square. I'm okay. I just talked too much. That's my sign that I'm done. I wasn't sure how many of you knew where the revenue for the CDC comes from. Arrow Lake Foundation is $10,000, and that is strictly for my my pay for director of the Arrow Lake Foundation. So my pay is $40,000 a year. So actually, $10,000 of that is paid by the Arrow Lake Foundation. And then Tennessee TAP, they contribute $35,000 a year. Smelter Service Corporation does $30,000. Kids on Stage is $5,000, and then the City of Mount Pleasant is $25,000. I'll be happy to answer any questions if anybody has any questions.
Donna, for one, I appreciate what you're saying. I really do. But on the other side of it, it looks like to me it should be more, I guess, self-funded, instead of, the city putting so much into it.
Well, when you think most cities, and I think that Mr. Bailey can, most cities contribute to their Chamber of Commerce.
I'm not saying.
No, I'm just saying. I understand, but I'm just saying that most cities, if there's Main Street program, that they put money into Main Street program, they put money into Chamber of Commerce, and this is the way that the city is doing now.
I know, like the Mount Pleasant Power System, they also involve families, they also involve in a barbecue, but it looks like to me, we need to, maybe you need to go out more to the other industry, and try to bring in more money. And I realize the CDC is also for our development, and I'm still waiting, for our downtown. It doesn't matter to me, and I honestly believe in taking short steps. I don't believe in doing the whole thing, I'm still haven't seen nothing except for what Mr. Barrier and his group is doing, and I'm thankful for that. But I'm just, I just think we need to go in a direction of getting more money from somewhere else beside the city. But that's just me. I'm just me. Mm-hmm. But like I say, I appreciate what you really do.
I'm involved on it, but in what those people do and knowing being involved in the barbecue festival and being involved in going out to get sponsorships, those people do contribute to the barbecue festival. The power company doesn't, not monetarily. They give in a service and that, but we do go out and get sponsorships. Being on the chamber, we don't get revenues from anybody else for the chamber other than members who belong to the chamber, mm-hmm. and that's what we're doing. The downtown renovation, I don't know if you're aware of, but the as far as Mr. Barrier doing it, it's a organization that does it. He bought some of the buildings, but those buildings are being renovated by his cost, not ours.
That's what I see, his cost.
Okay, well, let me finish though, Mike, to this, what you're not seeing that, because I've asked those questions, not objected to clarify. All the facades, those were grants to do that. I think what people are not understanding is that without a person to go look for these things, to do that, to put their time in, that's just the surface. Then you wouldn't get any of those things involved in that. I know that Donna's the only person that gets a salary, and thank God she does, because I don't, you know, for the hours that I know that I put in these different things and that. And we may not be able to give as much looking at, but I don't know what we would have, and if we were not to give that, to give it to Parks and Rec, but I know that, and we're on our fourth meeting, not our third, Parks and Rec, it's on my calendar, because we're meeting at 4 o'clock to 6 o'clock to do a plan of action of just like we're going to do that Saturday that Donna's taken and doing with us as part of the CDC, because she knows how to do it. I don't know what we do without it. I really don't. I don't know which direction we go in, and for the city to do that and to support these things. And last year, if you looked at the money that came in from the barbecue festival, because I know there were two people on the board last year who were ready to do away with the barbecue festival completely. They said it was costing the city money, and that we did a detailed cost analysis of that, and it doesn't make money for our city.
Sales tax revenue in the month of October goes up about $10,000. That money goes directly into the general fund.
That was just our
individual.
Pardon?
I said maybe that individual didn't help.
Well, we informed. No, those are the things we're trying to say. I don't know. So I don't know. I know we're looking at places to cut money. But I just think this is one of our well-placed money, and to look at the budget and involved with the CDC too, and maybe that's conflict of interest for me. I don't think it is.
No, actually, you serve on the CDC as representative for the city.
Yeah.
It's not a conflict of interest.
I just want to explain that the city of seeing that, because I question it, and I don't know.
My suggestion would be that we go to Donna individually between now and to the budget time for questions, suggestions.
For the next fiscal year.
We won't hash that out here. So I appreciate your report very much and what you
do.
Question for you though, Ben.
Sure.
Classic, because we're talking about, are you going to be involved with the airport doing the classic in the park? Is that an additional one?
She doesn't know that yet.
It just went out today.
I'm working with Thomas.
You already asked her.
I'm working with Thomas on it. Okay. We are going to work together on it.
No, I've got one question.
Sure.
It's on your breakdown in the very last page.
Mm-hmm.
And it's concerning tap and smelter. Where you're showing a $35,000 and a $30,000 respectively donation. I'm struggling with what the 18,333,34.
That's a breakdown for my salary.
Ah, thank you.
I did that, you know, because right off the $10,000 is Air Lake Foundation and Kids on Stage. That's all salary.
That helps.
Service
thank
on
you.
Their board.
Okay.
Yeah. Another question?
We'll all be to see.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll be back.
I'm going to make the dragon go now.
I'm going to head over to the Reluctant Dragon, and again, please come stop it and see it. It's a really good thing for the city. It's a good thing for live entertainment, live theater in Mount Pleasant. Thank you.
Thank you.
Moving on, item D, a proclamation, item C from Miss Annie L. Woodson. And we're just so delighted we're able to do this tonight. And if you would come to the podium, and any family member that wants to come with you, that's certainly all right.
We have the outlook for training, so.
Somebody's
got
a
picture.
She signed it already. Camera.
No,
picture.
A picture.
Oh,
it's fine. This is from the Office of the Mayor, Mount Pleasant, Tennessee, a proclamation. Be it hereby known that, whereas the city of Mount Pleasant is proud of individuals who bring personal pride,
belief in family, spiritual values, and bring recognition to our city. And whereas Ms. Annie L. Woodson possesses the above characteristics and is a dedicated and faithful church worker, a Christian woman possessing all qualities of Christianity, love and devotion to her family and church family, is active in her church services and fulfills her position as deaconess, usher, and choir member of Canaan AME Church, Columbia, Tennessee, with Dr. James McKissick as her pastor. And whereas Ms. Annie L. Woodson is the mother of four children, four stepchildren, and a host of other relatives that are dedicated to always show love, care, and concern for her, and affectionately calls her Mama Easy, or Sis. And whereas Ms. Annie L. Woodson is a faithful and vital member of community prayer group, and certain honors and recognitions are bestowed upon this individual by family, friends, and neighbors. And whereas the City of Mount Pleasant and its mayor and board of commissioners wish to join and honor this outstanding individual at this time, now therefore I, James L. Bailey Jr., mayor of the City of Mount Pleasant, do hereby recognize and proclaim February 27, 2017 as a day of honoring during African American History Month for Ms. Annie L. Woodson, and call upon all the citizens of the City of Mount Pleasant to join with us in recognizing our citizen and her family. Thank you.
All right.
Get my glasses off, put it on me now. We got one more. I'm going to take one. Y'all know I call her the Queen Mother, don't you? I don't never know until my water both became queens. Thank you, honey.
Thank you
very much. Those of you who may have noticed when I read that it said February 27th, that wasn't a typo. That will be Ms. Woodson's birthday, and she'll be 100 years old.
Tell her happy birthday.
That's just amazing. Hey, we're going to move into item 6, completion review of any unfinished business from prior meeting.
Mayor, I just wanted to point out that all five of these ordinances are second and final reading, so it's considered a public hearing if there's anybody that wants to speak towards them before final reading.
Everyone in the audience understand that each of these ordinances will be considered a public hearing, and you wish to speak, make yourself known at that point. Okay. Starting with the first one. Ordinance 2017-997, ordinance to adopt electronic citation regulations and fees for the City of Mount Pleasant Police Department and Municipal Court. Let the record show that no one spoke for or against this. Any questions? Motion to accept has been duly made. Is there a second?
Second.
Mr. Davis, any further discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Ordinance has passed, 997. Okay. 998, an ordinance setting community center rental fees for the City of Mount Pleasant, Tennessee. Anyone present to speak for or against? Record show no one spoke for or against. Any questions? Discussion?
Move approval.
White, you made the motion for?
Yes, please.
Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Jacqueline Granberry. Any further discussion? All in favor, I'll signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. That motion likely is passed. 999, an ordinance to amend ordinance 9857, ordinance appropriating the revenues, expenses of operating and maintaining the departmental functions of the city of Mount Pleasant, Tennessee for the fiscal year beginning July 1st, 2016 and ending June 30, 2017, providing an effective date. Anyone here to speak for or against?
Mayor, I just want to make sure the commission's aware that if it's passed as presented, the other half of the $25,000 for the CDC is in the budget amendment. Just want to be aware that you, that
you understand what you just said.
One of the items that you're...
And I wasn't aware, and I'm sure Ms. White wouldn't have been either. Jack wouldn't have been either.
I can just real briefly...
Just briefly tell what happened.
In the budget was $25,000, and that's what we have historically paid. We had to pass, we are supposed to, and Loretta and I insist on passing a resolution every time a not-for-profit is given money from the city. And when we presented the resolution to be passed, it felt like it would move forward if we cut the amount of money in half. And I believe, and Commissioner Davis chime in if I'm saying anything incorrectly, that we were going to look after the first 6 months of the fiscal year to determine about funding the other half of it at this point. And so it is in the budget amendment, and it's, so if you don't want it in there, we need to make that clear.
Right. Everybody understand that.
I have one question, okay? Do you think it would be in our best interest to list that on here just because of...
Well, it'll be in the minutes now.
Okay, good enough.
Yeah, that's one of the reasons I wanted to bring it up.
Okay.
I'm just not for funding the whole $25,000. I'm for funding some, but I am not. But that's me.
Okay. Now, this does not obligate us into the next budget year.
No.
Strictly in the budget year we're in now.
Yes.
I mean, because they get it this year, they couldn't get it right. Next year, or vice versa, don't get it, they couldn't get it.
Absolutely
so,
correct.
We're just working out in a budget. Does everybody understand that?
Sure.
And Commissioner Davis, I'm with you. I think that group moving forward needs to try to find outside funding because we've got a tough job to handle over the next few years in trying to make sure we've got the money for the things that are very, very important to us, and that's going to be water and sewer. But understanding that it's already in the budget, I make the motion we approve.
Right. Motion made that we approve it. Ms. White's reasoning is very similar to what I would consider it. Apparently, their budget and their workload was planned for this year, and if we're going to cut that, I would prefer to cut it in next year's budget rather than now and disrupt their plan of services. But that's
so you're saying go ahead and give them the $25,000?
No. The $12,500.
Right, okay.
$12,500.
Just what we committed to this year only.
We've already given them $12,500.
And the next year.
I understand that. I'm just saying.
I agree with what you're saying, with like Mayor is saying and Vice Mayor White. When we consider this new budget thing, we're going to them and saying, you need, we've got to cut back on our budget items and letting them know that since their budget is made for this year, to go ahead and fund it for this year, since it's in the budget.
I'm still getting a little confused when you say go ahead and budget it for this year.
No. For this current year right now.
Give them the rest of the 12.5. If they put 25 in.
Okay, budget, that's what I'm saying. So you're talking about going ahead and giving them the other 12.5.
Right. Yes, sir. This fiscal year.
Nothing
more. All right, but I mean, that puts it back up to the original 25 that we started out there and getting.
And no more.
No.
Just 25. Yeah, so here we are. Okay, she's 30. Then they can make their appropriate request for the budget next time.
For the 17-18 budget, they make their request. That's right.
Okay, but I'm still.
Well, in fair, and I understand what you're saying, Mark, but in fairness to them, to the CDC, when they laid their budget out for this year, and not necessarily and sitting on that committee as seeing their budget, they could adjust their budget, but it would take them adjusting their budget within a financial year that they had already allotted for.
I realize that, but they knew, 6 months ago, that's what we originally said was the 12.5.
Well, I don't want to bait this on.
I'm not
either. We can do this.
But
if the money wasn't in the budget, it'd be a moot question. But somehow, and I don't know how the money got in the budget. I don't understand that kind of thing. But that's okay. We'll watch for that in the future. But it is there. And I guess that's so. This time, if there's no further discussion.
We need a second.
No.
Second.
If there's, okay, it is.
Okay.
Any further discussion? Was anybody here for this? Here again, remember, this was a public hearing, if anybody had anything to say, but no one said anything, okay? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign? No.
No. Granby?
Four ayes, one no. Call the clerk, call the roll.
Granby?
No. Davis?
No.
Mr. Bailey?
Aye.
Blankenship?
Aye.
Mr. White?
Aye.
Three to two.
All right, 999,
D.
Ordinance 2017-1000, ordinance amending Title 14 of the City of Mount Pleasant, Tennessee Municipal Code to allow the mayor or the mayor's need to serve on the Municipal Planning Commission in the mayor's place. I think we all know, but now this was something that I asked for, that I think is pertinent to. It changes one word primarily. It goes from shall to the word may, which leaves it open for anybody that is mayor in the future. If they choose to serve, it'll be at their discretion. So it doesn't really impact anything except the current mayor's wishes. And is anyone at the public hearing? Anyone from the public here to speak on this issue? Okay, record show no one spoke on that. Chair will entertain a motion.
Motion.
Second.
Motion duly made and seconded. Any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Ordinance 1000 passes. 1001, an ordinance allowing the mayor to serve as an ex officio member of all city committees and boards. Anyone from the public here to speak on this in public hearing? Record show no one's present.
Make a motion, we approve.
All right, the motion been made to approve. Is it second? Duly seconded. Any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Like sign, that has passed also. Okay, item 7, financial and budget report, please.
Sure, this month, January is kind of our typical calm before the storm kind of thing. We're finishing up the, you know, Christmas and everything and everybody being out. And then, of course, January, we start to collect property taxes, but the most of them by far are currently being collected before the end of next week when they are due. So typically January is a little slower in that respect. The warm weather has impacted, of course, our gas sales down a little bit, but then again our usage was too. So we were all in all, our finances for the month of January ended up close to where they should be, around 58.3% of the budgeted amount of the revenues coming in, and the expenditure is right at the 60% or below mark. Of course, again, cash balances in the water fund. We did receive CDBG funding just last week. We received the last of the zone metering, and that's in the amount of $144,000 that we did receive for that project, and that does complete that project. As last month we had the that last
closeout
hearing, so we are that is being finalized. The bids, we took bids on 6 different items. When we got to looking at a lot of these services, we realized that things had not been bid out in quite some time. And so we'll look at later and have you approve the results of those bids. And then we still got a couple of more that we'll probably bring before you next month to try to get all of these up to date and back to where giving everybody a equal fair chance of providing the city these services.
What about them coming to bid out? Will we be in violation of anything?
just updating the meetings?
They were being updated.
They're good for 3 years.
They're good for 3 years. Some of them were overdue.
I'm sorry, I wanted to know before the newspaper asked.
Yes, some of them were overdue. And so we were trying to make sure we got those back up. The comptroller's office recommends it every 3 years. And some of them had been longer than that.
I want to thank you. I know I wore them to death about these procedural things and so forth, but we have to do a better job.
Yeah, we didn't do it. Well, I had not read it. We had gotten anything on it. I had not read that.
Well, somebody's because I asked. Okay. And I know what.
And I'm glad we're doing it because we in the past have gotten bitten in the rear end by it, and I'm glad you're doing that to know that, and I'd rather just know it and have it brought to forth that we are in the process of doing that and that we have done that. So,
yeah. Well, we want to give everybody, of course, I know the board's desire to try to stay as local as possible, but at the same time, we want to try to make sure we're getting the best price. I was disappointed in some of the results of some of the bids. I was pleased with some of the results.
Well, I know you've been very frustrated, and again, I thank you for taking me through the bidding process, and I don't know if the rest of y'all know, but Loretta took us painstakingly through the process of these bathrooms for the park. Oh my goodness, it has been a nightmare headache trying to get us lay people.
Bathrooms are one of the hardest things to bid. And it's just
it's amazing how many little widgets there are.
We wanted to do as many things out as possible, and as many services, which made her have to sit down and write bid specs for things that we couldn't find online or anywhere else. So it took a while at that point.
Well, I think it says a lot about our city, and I liked what Donna said. It's a, you know, our industrial thing. You know, our baby may be ugly, but it's getting better. You know, and we have to own up to some of the things. And I didn't say ask that to get you.
He's procedural stuff.
Yeah, but it has been some time since some of these were bid out. So,
thank you.
Thank you very much.
We'll need a motion to accept the financial report.
Make a motion that we accept the financial report.
Second. Motion made and duly seconded. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. The report has been accepted. Okay. You want to take over now, Kay?
Basically, the monthly report I put together from all the departmental reports that you have in your packet, and then I take this and turn it into the State of the City that will be out March 1st in hard copy and on the website. So that my report comes out at that point on the 1st of March. And you have everything in your packet that will be in there. And that does not need to be approved in the second move.
Who's the new hire?
Sam Hansen and sanitation.
He's a local graduate from here.
He's from Mason Lane.
Amy and
Harold
Hansen, their son.
Amy and Harold's son.
He worked for 3 years part time.
And he took advantage of the Tennessee promise, and went to Homewall and graduated. I'm very proud of him. He's one of my former students.
My son Brian Gray, he's back to work, right?
March 1st.
Okay. He's taken some sick leave as well. Yeah.
Item 9, do we have any special?
We do not have any. There is not a wastewater liaison report, so there's nothing to report this time, and there's not a Mount Pleasant
Gas report. I'll make a comment just right quick, and y'all know me, I'm all over the water and the sewer, but we had a little bit better rate this year than we did last year on the water sold versus produce. Thank y'all.
Still very frustrating, though.
It is, but I know everybody's working at it, so that's what's important.
Moving to item 10, new business. Resolution 20173, resolution of city credit cards and lockbox local.
The purpose of this is on in front of you is because we found that the current credit card had signature files from people that have not been with the city for quite some time, and to change that, because it was originally a Bank of America account before it turned First Tennessee, we were going to have to drive to Spring Hill to change that. So we're basically going local to a community first with these credit cards and a lockbox across the street. So we just need to have that, the resolution authorizing it, and then we'll get the signature cards all taken care of.
So what have we done, you know, to make sure this doesn't happen? I'm talking about, you know, like ex-city manager or whatever, whoever. You know, what have we done to make sure that...
Well, your name specifically in the resolution, it doesn't just say city manager, it says Kate Collier.
Okay.
So it has the name of the position and the name of the person as well.
Yeah. Okay.
So the people whose names are on file on the signature card, they would not have been able to sign it anyway, but we just need to get the paperwork taken care of.
Further discussion. Just for everybody's, because there was some discussion during the work session about who was actually backing that card, and they're fine. It's an Arkansas bank that pretty much specializes in credit card use. They've got a very good, nice asset liability statement, so they're in fine shape.
Further discussion? Chair will entertain a motion, please.
I'll make a motion. Resolution 2017-3.
Okay, is there a second to that, brother?
Seconded.
Been duly seconded. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All like sign. Passed on first reading.
It's a resolution. It's passed.
Hmm.
It's a resolution.
Oh, it is.
So it's passed.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Okay. Can't get used to resolutions and ordinances. Whereas a resolution for the City of Mount Pleasant, Tennessee, authorizing interlocal agreement for automatic response of fire and rescue services with Murray County Fire and Rescue.
At the work session on Thursday, we had a PowerPoint presentation. I don't know if there's any other questions, but we have fire here, the chief and assistant chief, if there are.
Again, I hate to be negative tonight. But anyway, I appreciate what y'all are doing. But I guess my main concern is, you know, when our employees goes out to a bar, you know, and we have an accident on the way, and then that means, you know, that we're, you know, if they get hurt and they're out of work, that means we're going to have to hire somebody. And I'm just not, you know, pray that nothing ever happens.
Yes.
But I mean, that's a big chance that we're taking, you know, when we go out
and
to
they-
a call like that, because I mean, you know, because of the roads, and you know, and we're going to be moving pretty fast. I mean, we might say we're not going to go fast, but we're going to move pretty fast to go to that.
And they are doing the same for us on our behalf, too.
I understand.
So, yeah.
I understand that.
No, I understand
your
concerns, Mike. And like I said, if it was something that we've been doing every day and a lot of, I'd probably look at more, but, you know, the number of calls that we probably will
that's
be doing or
takes.
Have done.
That's all it takes.
I know it only takes one, but
that's all it takes.
He could do that here inside the city limits too, running the calls. But
I mean, that could also
consideration you look at.
I understand, but I mean, that could also go, I guess, you know, if you're thinking about inaction, you know, other people, you know, other areas. Why would I inact if I can get the fire department to my house anyway? Why would I want to be in the city limits? But my main concern, you know, is, I guess, you know, taking a chance on our employees, you know, being involved in that. I mean, that chance is already there when they go to a bar or whatever inside the city, but I'm talking about going outside the city.
And this is something if it's passed on a resolution, which is one reading, and the chief and the assistant chief are going to be monitoring it, and it is more than you anticipated, we certainly can come back to you and just say, we've tried automatic aid, it's been more than we anticipated. We can take it away as easily as we're putting it in. So it's not permanent.
But I mean, that could be too late. I mean, you know, there could be you going out to something like that, like a slant off like that, and it could be several people involved in an accident. And I just don't want to take, that's me. Again, I'm just one.
Well, let's look at it from another point of view, and I understand what you're saying. When I looked at it, because I was the same way, why I was going to cover other places. But then, on the other hand, what
one, the oldest, when, you know, you design Christian Academy, Hampshire Unit School, it, you know, it's the fact that those are kids. If the school catches on fire, we want as much protection as we can to get the kids out of there and make sure they're safe.
Oh, I understand that.
And I mean, that's what, and actually the treatment, water treatment facility is ours anyway, but I'm saying that's what sort of got, and with the places listed on here, I'm back to what they're saying. More than likely, it's not going to be an every call, but then I understand what you're saying, it don't take but one time. But then on the other hand, do we want to leave? Do we not want to assist where we really think we need, which would be useful?
And Commissioner Granberry, one thing that was said at their work session too is last year there were 5 calls and we went to all of them anyway without this agreement.
And that's under a mutual aid, you know, contract or agreement that it's had right now. So, yeah, I mean, Mike, I understand the concerns, and like I said, it's an accident that can happen.
But I mean, somebody like Columbia
may not happen.
Columbia could do it easy. Where, you know, we've only got one, you know, and that's why, you know, if somebody got hurt, that's why we would have to hire more people.
So you had 5 the last year?
Yeah.
I thought I remembered that. I couldn't remember. I knew it was a single digit.
Yeah, they had 5 calls in our area that we were
responding
to.
And we already did it.
I mean, they had a lot more calls than just 5 in our area that
right.
we went to.
Right.
Can I answer your thoughts?
Sure.
Well, number one is that strategically we was looking at how does Maury County and Mount Pleasant benefit by changing the wording to automatic instead of mutual, because data shows that we're going the majority of the time. When it comes to having a wreck, you're right. It could happen in the city, outside the city, but we put a lot of time, effort, and training into due regard when we drive, always looking around. That's something that's always in the back of our minds, but it's not that we're always training on it. I mean, it's a daily talk about due regard for the public, because they're not looking for us, so we're looking for them now, that history.
Well, I mean, again, they could bring, I guess, people that's outside the city limits or inside the city limits wanting to secede from being in the city limits if I can get fire protection. I mean, there's just other ways to look at it.
My third point is, this is not necessarily all for citizens and county citizens, it's for us. The more people we get, the safer we are. And these are trained, credentialed people that are coming to us just like we're going to them. We have 4 people, and then we do a call out, we may get 10 or 12. If they bring their 5 or 6, each scene industry standard is 16 firefighters, just to be safe. So it's a lot for us as well, not necessarily just for citizens and county.
They have to reciprocate the agreement. They come to us just as
right.
they go to them.
All right, during your presentation, didn't you not say that there might be an opportunity down the road with ISO to have reduced rates?
Absolutely. We're 3 now. With the staffing that they come and the credible water source they can bring with them with tankers, yes, we could, and I don't want to say we can get to a 2, but.
Right, but they're down the road.
Murray County is a
9? Yeah, Murray County wants to benefit, obviously, from that too.
But you have to talk to your insurance, you know, like mine is Farm Bureau, and I talked to them on the last one.
They are the reason that this did become a catastrophic situation in the early 2000s. Farm Bureau was probably the only company that was not concerned about it. Others were already, I know, one company for sure that the rates had gone up almost 200% because what's happened, GPS has now located people with a Mount Pleasant address or Columbia address, and they don't live inside the city, and all of a sudden goes down to Watts Hill. Columbia goes down all the way, well past the interstate. So that's what, and this will come back again in my opinion. But my main concern, not concern, but the reason I'm going to support this and vote for it is because you make it save a life.
Absolutely.
I'm not concerned about the house particularly, but I am really concerned about maybe we can save one child's life. Or one old elderly person's life who couldn't get out of that house. And, you know, I'm willing to take the gamble with it as long as we're fully insured. And I've been assured that we're fully insured.
And we have double checked.
Probably ask that question
again.
Because that's my main concern.
You know, one of the things we're really looking at this, and we've been in talk for 6 to 8 months now with Maury County, is historically we're going anyway on a delayed response when we get there. Now, with a confirmed fire, I'm talking confirmed only, I'm not talking wrecks, medical, they still got to go through mutual aid. But confirming, when someone calls 911, they're going to dispatch Maury County and us at the same time. So, for instance, Red Row, which is not in our city, we're automatically going, and there's potential, to, and it really is potential there to save one, because that's right outside our city, or any of our boundaries. So that's why, strategically looking at benefits of ISO, and just the life safety aspect, why not? It's a resolution. Come back, evaluate it 6 months if it's not working.
Okay.
Not an ordinance, resolution. Get rid of it just as quick as we put it in.
With all that in mind, I move approval.
Motion's been made to approve this resolution. Is there a second to that?
I second.
Duly seconded. Any further discussion? We haven't had many motions tonight just yet. I don't expect every resolution, every ordinance, whatever, to get full support. Everybody on this board is entitled to their own opinion. It's not going to be any hard feelings for me, and I hope none of the rest of us come back votes their opinion. That's what we're here for. And we'll keep it. It'll all be civil, and that's the way it'll be. And expect your opinion always.
All right.
All right. No further discussion. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign.
No.
Let the record show that there's four ayes and one no, please. Okay. Number five, a resolution. City of Mount Pleasant, former City Attorney Quinn Brown, insured as delinquent tax attorney, and set her compensation.
What that is no, I'm not delinquent. I'm past that now.
I've checked your tattoo. You are.
She is a delinquent. She is a delinquent.
That's just the standard resolution. We'll have to file suit on the taxes at the end of March, and I just have to attach a resolution to it.
Okay.
This is part of your contractual agreement with the city, too. That I'm supposed to go after the delinquent taxes.
Okay. Further questions on this?
I move it.
We move for approval. Is there a second?
I second.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Resolution is also passed. Item 217-6, resolutions of corporations and LLCs for treasury management services.
Mayor, it was brought to our attention through Ms. Garner's office that we needed to increase the ACH amount that we're transferring money, especially when we have a payroll week. And as you can see, we got this format from a bank. It's not even in our font yet. We're going to correct that, but this is necessary to get the ability for us to, anybody that's named in this resolution can make changes like that. And we're not getting ourselves in a bind when it comes to ACH amounts.
Okay.
Anything else I missed on that?
Does everyone understand what we're talking about? This is probably a good problem. It happens in business all the time. They have to get the ACH increase so there's nothing out of the way.
And there are some bills that we pay that they will not accept any other type of payment. And so, for instance, buying gas, natural gas, to do that through an ACH.
All right. Chair will entertain a motion, please.
I'm going to recuse
myself. Go ahead and state that.
Yeah, I'm going to recuse myself from this due to my involvement with First Farmers.
Mrs. with First Farmers, yes.
And I'm not going to accuse myself. I will just announce for the record that I am an honorary director of Farmers Merchants Bank, not serving on any board that does anything. We're kind of the old guys been turned out to pasture. We'll go ahead and say that's in case somebody said, well, he's a Farmers Merchants. I was for many years, and I certainly agree with statements like that. Any further discussion?
A motion.
Is there a second? Motion second. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Okay, that's going to be four ayes and one abstention. The motion is passed. Okay. Approval of various bids.
It's just electronic format, but
you don't have
any extra copies. You don't have copies? Anybody else need it?
We Work hard copy. We got a little machine, yes, sir.
We got it, we just haven't got it ready to go yet.
We don't know how to use it.
Probably all on paperback, this.
No. We'll go through this as quickly as we can. Sometimes if there was only one bid, it's clear we move forward.
The first, we start out with the janitorial bid. We actually received one sealed bid. We did receive a bid late that I was not able to accept because it was late and it was also not in a sealed envelope that is required. So therefore, we could not accept that bid. Therefore, that only left the one other bidder, that being Steam Masters LLC. What we did with this bid was basically City Hall and the community center, and we also asked them to include a what we called extra cleaning. A lot of times, especially in the community center, not so much here at City Hall, but in the community center, we may have a group that has left city in a big mess, and we go along with some of what his fees are, and we wanted to get a good basis of how much it would cost us to have that extra cleaning done. And so
that's
we
on an as-needed basis. That's not a regularly scheduled.
No, that's not a regularly scheduled. That would be on a or if the city was having some kind of special event that you wanted to have some extra cleaning done. So we did ask for that to be included. And so the monthly total on that was, including the community center, was $912 per month.
How often do they come?
They come once a week and do the total cleaning, and then they come back for kind of a spot shift.
It's City Hall only,
City Hall. They come back and do empty trash, do small.
But they're not going to the community center but once a month?
They're only going as needed. Well, we ask them to.
Well, we did include the monthly.
Right. We're entitled to one per month before we start paying extra.
And then if we have somebody that leaves
one per week.
No, there's something. I'm not. There's something. This bid needs to be sure.
Maybe it's been on once a month.
You said once weekly on the City Hall.
Right.
And my question was, how
often? And we did include the, we did include the, in that $912 did include the community center.
Once a month or once a week?
I'm reading it here, it would be once a week for being included in that.
Well, that makes sense. Because it's just a big room. So
those
would just be
okay.
That is an overall savings from what we're currently paying now,
yeah,
for sure.
Yeah. We're currently paying, we're currently paying $816 per month and with no cleaning of community center whatsoever.
Further discussion? Chairman, entertain a motion, please.
Make a motion to accept this presented.
Do we need to vote on each one individually?
Okay. Motion made. Is there a second, please?
I'll second.
Duly seconded. Any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. That bid has been accepted, please.
And the next one is the y'all mowing, code.
Next one is the window washing.
Oh. The window washing, we had one bid on that. It seems sometimes that we may be able to do this ourselves, and I think that might be that something that the board might want to look at is that maybe our own staff do this instead of having somebody doing it regularly on a monthly basis. Because as you can see, it's that might be a cost saving.
What happened to the county, I guess, the flowway that we had, coming down doing some work at one time? I guess from the sheriff's office or whatever. What was his name?
The trustees are still available. You get what you pay for, and you have to provide them lunch every day they work for you.
But the one that we had, I think they was...
I think they send the same one every time, do they?
Probably doesn't need to do it anymore.
I mean, that's strictly a voluntary thing with them. They get one day off. They get one day after they work one-to-one type.
I mean, I didn't know. I guess from the people I talked to, they're all pleased with him.
I think he did something where he couldn't come in.
Well, you got to go get him. You got to take him back, and you're responsible for him.
Yeah.
You don't have to go after him if they escape, which that's fair, but they do that. And the biggest thing you got to watch about the trustees is they're working for 12 years. There's some good ones, there's some bad ones.
Well,
there's a great temptation to get them drugs and things.
And we have to supervise them.
I just knew we had that at one time.
We still have community service work for people that need the hours, but again, you do get what you pay for, and you have to monitor them.
We done it at the shop for a while. It's aggravating a lot.
So that's something that we do not want to do no more.
No,
there might be a project that comes up where it fits in, but ongoing, regular.
It could be, and we wouldn't.
Yeah.
You got to put somebody with them.
You can't put the bucket out there and say clean them and leave.
I look up sometime, they'll be way down the street, but it's courthouse.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, that's
that's
$300.
For a month. And I don't necessarily think that we need City Hall's windows cleaned every month.
Well, could he give us like a price for just doing it?
That's what my recommendation, that would be my recommendation.
What
would
did
be
the
to
bid
go
say?
Back to him. The bid said per month, but my recommendation would be to go back to him and say, because he was the only bidder, and to say, okay, would you do this? How much would you do this on a per?
As we need it.
As needed,
yeah,
basis.
Yeah.
I bet he'd do that, too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think so.
We need to put this in on hold?
That would be my recommendation. Let's put that on hold and see if he would do that.
Dribble everybody to do that.
Yeah.
I hope we let the doctor do that. He's a good man.
Yeah, because you have the option to not accept the bid.
Do we need to... Quinn, do we need to document this any further? In fact, we're not going to receive it. We need a motion.
It doesn't hurt to do a motion to reject the bid.
I think we should do a motion that we would reject this bid until further information is gathered. Chair, entertain that motion.
You make a motion to reject this bid until we get more information.
Second?
I'll second.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Like sign. Now you're cleaned up, man.
This is basically bid for the base hourly rate is for the pretty much the cleaning, mowing of properties that codes has deemed have to be cleaned up, and that the city ends up being responsible to do it, but we do bill it back to the owners.
Do we have any idea, and I don't see anybody here with planning or zoning, do we have a list of properties that need
to... Oh, yes. Mm-hmm.
approximately?
It's not large.
It's not that large. It's usually repeat offenders,
okay.
And it'll pick up, you know, once the grass starts growing.
Once the grass starts growing.
The hardest ones are the people that don't live in town, and we don't have much teeth there. I mean, we have two or three going into court this month.
And that's the problem, Bill. I mean, especially with the time we had with the banks foreclosing. You couldn't. Nobody owned anything.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Nobody claimed on the
owner would.
So we choose to go out and clean it up after plenty of notice, so that it doesn't. It's not an eyesore.
Yeah, then you got a pile of lien on it. Eventually, you get your money.
You might.
Yeah. After they go to court, are you recording it in the registrar's office?
Yeah, this will be the first time that we've had anybody in court this month.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. It should
just make sure you record that judgment in the registrar's office.
It shook some people up in town.
Yeah,
we were finally.
I mean, it's going to be $12.
Yeah.
Whatever number of pages.
Yeah, whatever number of pages.
But it shook some people up.
Dave's pushing. Is that Timmy?
When we started.
Yes. He's the only bidder. He's our current contractor.
Okay. So I need to rescue myself because I think my name.
That's smart.
I'll make the motion. We accept this bid.
He's the only bidder.
The thing that turns a lot of people away is we do require insurance and workers' comp. And that
a lot of the independent ones don't have that. Yet.
They don't have that, and for them, they don't feel that it is cost benefit beneficial for them to get that. I would disagree with that, but. That's most of the
feeling. We require $1 million policy to work on the ground. Some sense, okay. We
did
had
a
motion
second?
To accept.
Did we get a second?
Second. And Mr. Davis asked a question, just for the record, that since this is his nephew, would he have a conflict of interest? I don't personally think that he does. It's marginal gray area. If he feels uncomfortable voting on it,
just let him
recuse himself.
Yeah. All right,
I'll just let them somebody coming back. So I'll just excuse
them.
Okay. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like, sign. 4-4. 1, Mr. Davis has recused himself for the vote. Pass.
Pest control. With pest control, we did have two bids. They were fairly close. The bid document included the gas department. However, on our sheet, we did not have it included, so we made sure that both bidders gave us a price, included a price with the gas department also. They, like I said, they're very close, and I did verify that Pestarid does not charge for yearly inspections, but he does do inspections. He includes that in his monthly fee. But I did verify that.
Who is that?
It was Pestarid.
Yeah,
where are they?
Both of these are local. One of them is from Summer. The Reliable's from Summertown, and Pestarid is out of Columbia.
Pestarid's been doing it before I got here. I do not know.
Remember's name?
They're not.
Yeah.
Who was doing it before you got here?
Pestarid.
Same firm.
Who does it? Mr. Hill? Is that Pestarid, Mr. Hill?
Yeah.
And Reliable is.
The trucks park over here on the corner of Pleasant.
Reliable.
That's where the parents live, and that's where they meet this boy. I can't think his name well. They end up buying Walker's business years ago.
I'm talking about Kenneth Walker.
Yeah, that's his
name.
Okay.
And are we satisfied with the work that Pestarid does currently for us? Have we had any problems?
There's always
bid time, it's time to remember if there is a problem and something they didn't do or wouldn't do or shouldn't do or whatever, because these bids are very close. But
very pleasant people to work with.
Okay.
We had spiders to come and talk to us. Got little toy spiders.
No further discussion. Chair will entertain a motion.
Make a motion that we take the
Pestarid
bid.
Okay, motion been made to take the Pestarid bid. It's been duly seconded. Further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Like sign. That bid has been accepted, please.
The next is the uniform rental.
this is probably the one that gave me the biggest heartburn in trying to come up with the specs. You find out how many different shirts y'all wear.
And there is only one bidder, and it's our current provider.
Yeah. After discussion with the other uniform Aramark, they would not guarantee a price for more than 8 months, so therefore they declined to bid on it because we weren't requiring that they at least hold their price for 1 year, and then with a 2 year extension on that, if we were still pleased and they would be willing to offer it at that price. They wanted a 5 year, but we said the most that we could go out there was 3.
I know I'm reading this wrong. Paper towels, $6.42 a roll.
Yeah, but the rolls are.
and they
include the. They also provide the dispensers.
It just stood out. I'm sorry.
What about the ones in the restroom? They never.
Ours are not, but I have requested that they're not in one currently, but that was one part of the bid.
I wish they were instead of just a roll sitting there, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Especially in public restrooms.
I don't think they, Cintas provides the equipment for those rolls. I think those machines
are ours.
I think this is like at our different plants where they provide their paper towels and the actual rolls. So I think we can purchase our own paper towels here.
Do they have the janitor? Do they even have the key to those?
No.
That's why they're not in there. They can't.
No, the janitorial's been changing these here now. But the these were primarily the gas and the
wastewater.
Primarily the gas and the wastewater.
Mm-hmm. And the water plant.
Mm-hmm. Like I said, this one was the one that gave me the most heartburn.
So this bid, how does it compare with what you were paying, up or down?
It's roughly close to the same.
Same people were doing it.
They're also, aren't they the state?
Yeah, they have a
state bid.
We're operating on the state bid.
Well,
they are the state bid, but we went ahead and bid it out anyway.
What's the difference?
We had other companies coming to us that said they wanted to bid on it, so we put it out and let the others bid as well. Aramark was really wanting to bid on it until the last minute when they wouldn't guarantee their prices.
Do we know what the state bid was?
No, I don't. He's supposed to get with me next week on that.
I think we ought to wait until we see. Because I know there are some instances where we could piggyback on to what the state may be doing.
State contract price, though.
But not if we've already accepted
until we get
one.
That.
No, right, but you don't have to accept it. You can defer it to next month.
We can receive it.
Why don't we defer this vote until the next meeting?
Legally. Mm-hmm. I would think it's okay, too.
Yeah.
I'd like to see what the state bid is, just for a matter of comparison. We know where we are. We may be paying too much. Maybe getting a real bargain.
Well, the reason that the reason we bid this out in the first place was we were having so many companies. I had a couple of different companies come to us. I would be really interested, and then when it comes down to it, we're not going to guarantee our cost.
I commend you for the work you did. I'm really familiar with it, but it's a good thing occasionally to bid these things anyway, and the work goes into it, and you know where you stand. So, okay, we'll have a motion in to defer this until our next meeting.
Yes.
All right. All in favor? Who made the motion? Twice.
Yes.
Second.
I'll second.
You're the second. All in favor? Signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Okay. That motion will be deferred until the next meeting.
Last one, office supplies. We got 2 bids. My recommendation would be to accept A to Z Office, which they are local. Got another company out of Reno, Nevada. They wanted to use recycled paper and remanufacturing ink cartridges, and I have not had good results. My experience has not been good using the remanufacturing supplies. And again, their base discount was
was more, it was less. A to Z gave us, has a good breakdown on their discounts. We get there who our current provider is. We get good service. We get the next day.
I make a motion that we approve this bid.
Okay, motion been duly made. Is there a second?
Second.
Second, duly seconded. Any further discussion? All in favor of A to Z bid, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. That bid has been accepted. Okay. Item 11, general comments from citizens.
One.
What?
Where are we on?
Oh, excuse me. I wrote it down, still didn't see it. I was,
we have anything. I was telling we had one more item.
Oh. Yeah, board appointments.
He left off an item.
Yeah, we moved something in front, and I thought I wrote it down, written somewhere. Don't see it.
Recreation and then planning.
Yeah, let's see. We moved D of the mayor's appointments from 5. We moved it till after item 10 was completed. We'll make it item F. This time, I would like to make 2 appointments, please. First one being to serve in the absence of the designated representative of the mayor. I would like to present to a request that Mr. Bill White, Commissioner White, be my designated for that.
For planning commission? Is that what you said?
Mm-hmm. For planning commission.
I'll make a motion.
Okay. Motion been duly made. Is there a second to that?
Second that.
Duly seconded. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Like sign. That motion has passed. On the second thing, we had a gentleman suggested from the Recreation Committee, Mr. Bedford Smith, to serve on that board. This is our recommendation. We're not bound to accept it, but I will accept it. And I'd put before the board his appointment to the Recreation Committee.
I'll make a motion. We accept that.
A motion been made. Is second?
I'll second that, please.
Okay, been duly seconded. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Smith has been appointed, will be appointed to the Recreation Committee. Now, yes,
sir. Yes, sir. Dwight Green.
Come up here, Mr. Green, please. Come on up.
Don't put me through all this funny.
Stand up so we can hear you.
I'll stand up.
What we were trying to do is not to punish anybody, but we need to have a record of who you are and where you're from, even though we know you, because 3 or 4 years ago something may come up, or 6 months from now.
Yeah.
And speaking to say your name and your address and your business.
And keep in mind too, when anybody watches the video afterwards, they hear a voice they don't see.
I don't know if they know that. You're gonna be on television now?
Dwight Green, 102 Gardenia. I've got one question. Where are we? Where are we on the new system for the water sewer plant? I mean,
you want me to address it?
Yes, sir.
We have submitted to the state of Tennessee Department of Environment Conservation what we call a CAPER. It's
Corrective
Action Plan Engineering Report. We submitted that a few months ago, hopefully to have heard from them by now. But the state, as you well know, and federal government, they move at their pace and we move at ours. And we have not gotten that back. That we can't do anything until we get that acceptance from the state. And I hope to push to move that on through the agenda and get this thing on up. We're also working on financing to help do some of this stuff.
Okay, did the piece of equipment they bought to go at the sewer plant, did that work?
The biobag?
Biobag, yes.
The pilot study was successful. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
They said that was their recommendation to go with biomag. That's what we sent to state.
Oh, good. And in the second question,
another reason that was, I reckon to go that route because it's much cheaper.
Mm-hmm. Than building a new plant.
Okay, the second one is, where are we on the Mount Joy water line project?
I'm going to give that one to our city manager, even though I've had some correspondence with it, even as late as today.
Thank you.
Wait, stop on me, that alone.
You ran into that, didn't you?
The project is complete. As you know, when you have construction, there's some dirt that needs to settle. There's grass that needs to be, seed needs to be planted and straw over that. They had their closeout hearing for that grant in Lewis County, because most of it's in Lewis County, last month as well. Okay. So they're doing final payoffs there with that.
Good.
And not everybody that wanted water got water, but once the money was out, the money was out.
No. Kate, everybody who applied in time, though.
Yes, everybody who applied originally in 2014. Originally got water.
Yeah. And was there not some money held over to make sure that the work was completed as far as the sewing and everything?
We have 100% performance bond. Self-Central Tennessee Development District requires retainage to be paid out. Yeah. Like, we've asked that question two or three times. So what we have right now is a performance bond.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Green. Any further comments? Anybody else?
I just wanted to mention that right now at the Murray County Commission meeting, that they are moving forward on our behalf to do a grant through Murray County for the water loss project, $500,000 there too. And I did email them all saying I couldn't attend. We did have Tosha here today for a scheduled every other year visit. And minor things, but nothing that's going to be very bad.
I just got an email, the grant passed unanimously.
Okay, good. Hey. So 22 votes.
Wow, unanimous.
We've only been there about five times.
They get tired of hearing it. We get persistent.
Okay. Any commissioner have anything to say? Thank you, Chairman. Entertain a motion in for adjournment.
My little one was diagnosed with flu yesterday.